work? Am I here? Can we hear me?
Is the question. Did I miss your stream? No, ain't Jam Jam. Starting soon stream. Guys, can we hear me? I don't want to keep talking unless I know. That is the question. Muted. Knew it. Is this better? Is this working? No. Can you guys not? Yes. Guys, am I being trolled really badly right now? Or can we hear me? It's working. Okay. Phew. I've been having dramas with my mic. How are we all? Guys, it's the first time I've done like the starting soon stream on my own. Big girl and all that. So I'm glad it all worked. Oh, let me get my dog. I think she wants to come in. Molly, come on. This is Lolly, in case you don't know her. Hey Craig, how are you? I had to take her to the vets today, guys. And I had to walk because my parents aren't here and we live up some fat hill. Anyway, I get to the vets, which is like a fair walk away because, no guys, I don't drive. I should drive, but I don't drive. And the vets was closed. So I woke up very early to take her to the vets and the vets was closed. And do you know what? The vets texted my mum to let her know that the vets would be closed. And she didn't tell me. So yeah, but it was a nice walk. It was a nice walk. Hello, Kelly. How are you doing? Hey, Pacific Night. Lovely to see you all. Guys, if you've seen my streams recently, you know that I was at the Lost House recently. And their setup is so good and it's made me realise I really want like a new setup. I mean, it's comfy and all sitting on my bed, but I just want to switch it up. It needs to look a bit more profesh. Profesh. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? But anyways, how's everyone's weeks going? Guys, I got back to Spain yesterday. Yeah, I got back to Spain yesterday. Yesterday? No, day before. Guys, the flight, honestly, I travel quite a bit. I don't think I've ever experienced such a bad flight before in my life. Like, it was everything that could have gone wrong literally went wrong. I can't believe it. And I didn't get back, I didn't get in until like 2 a.m. in the morning probably. That's why I didn't end up flying yesterday. I mean, coming on stream yesterday. Because I was literally exhausted. Because I've had quite a busy like week anyway. Oh, tell us more. Well, you asked for it, Craig Pacific, let me tell you. So, I actually get there on time. Well, relative time, you know, enough time. Because I know the airport quite well. I've done it a few times. I get there. Honestly, guys, I must have been in the queue for like over an hour to check my bags in. Like, it was ridiculous, the queue. And we were not moving. There was only one person on the desk, right? With so many people. Like, it was crazy. I was literally like, what is going on? So anyway, I finally get there. Bearing in mind, I'm checking in my bag as like my gate is open. So like my actual gate, like they've started boarding, they've said. I get to the desk and the guy, first of all, I have my luggage with me, which is the same amount of luggage that I had. He made me pay £33 extra, but he wouldn't take Apple Pay. My debit card, I don't know why, was in my suitcase. So I had to open up my case to try to find my debit card. But bearing in mind, guys, I never pack organised. So I was literally like scrolling through trying to find this debit card. And then find the debit card. Bearing in mind, the guy has been so rude and was like, you've only got 1 minute to sort this out. I'm literally like I was honestly in shock. So anyway, he's then like, you've got to run to the gate now. Like, you've got to go. Bearing in mind, guys, this airport that I go to is huge, right? I'm running through the airport. I haven't eaten and I was like starving. Hadn't like had any water or anything. Run through the airport, get to the gate, right? And the gate's like closed off. And I'm like, shit, I've missed my flight. Oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? Like, I start panicking. To then find out that they hadn't even opened the gate. So the guy made me panic, made me run through the airport like a crazy woman to find out that they hadn't even started boarding the plane and the plane was actually late. The plane was an hour late. But they were like, you couldn't go and get like, but they were like, no, you can't go and get food, whatever. So I didn't end up eating. I think I ate at like, let's say like 12. I hadn't eaten until I got back, which was like 2 a.m. Honestly, but I ended up waiting. I ended up queuing. And then when I got to Spain, you know, like, I don't know, guys, when you get off a plane and you just walk through the airport, you know, you have to get them buses sometimes. I've never had to get one of them buses in Spain. We ended up having to get one of them buses, like, which literally drove around the airport. That probably took another 15 minutes. Honestly, you know when you're just like, I've never experienced this before in my life. I actually was thinking the whole way, I was like, I feel like my luggage is going to be not there when I get there. You know, and it's just been so bad. You're just like, I was so happy. I was really prepared for my luggage not to be there when I arrived in Spain because I was just like, honest, that's what I thought. Honestly, guys, I hate that. The shuffles, a bloody nightmare. So honestly, because I do usually stream on a Monday, but I was honestly dead to the world. And my parents aren't home at the moment, so this little one is usually joined at my mum's hip, which is usually why she's not in stream with me. But because my mum's not here, she's literally joined at my hip. And I went to bed. And she, like, proper, like, she literally, like, came, like, she was like, I need to sleep with you. she talks to me. No, but, you know when dogs are looking at you, like, come on, let me in bed. So she's been sleeping with me. But the first night, I forgot that she was sleeping with me. So I was literally lying there asleep. And she moved. And honestly, she moved and I was like, oh. She scares me so much when she sleeps with me, but it's cute. I am Pacific. I'm safe and sound. I'm back in Spain. If you guys have seen my story on Instagram, like, what the hell? It is so, like, nice and sunny at the moment here. So it's so nice to be back. And the one big thing that I've noticed, actually, from being back here is how I can't take England in like December time when literally it's dark by 4 p.m. Like, I didn't realise how much it affected me, but by like, because it's like 4 p.m, right, and it's dark, I'm mentally thinking it's like 7. By 7 p.m, I'm literally ready for bed. It's crazy. And like, I think it gets dark here like 6 now, which I still find a bit much, but I get used to it. But I just can't be dealing with the English weather. Hello, Freeze. Lovely to see you. How are you today? England does destroy our body. Craig, I would love to think that I can move back to England, but... Ah, Joseph, thank you so much for the follow. I don't actually think... Oh. This is a tune. Guys, sorry, really off topic. This is Willow Smith, isn't it? I didn't know Willow Smith sung. But I actually didn't know. But yeah, no, honestly, like, England, I can't do England winter. Like, when it's dark, it's grey, it's cold. I actually don't think I could live there full time anymore, like at all. Like, obviously, I'm lucky enough that I have the option to be able to either live here or be here and then obviously go back to the UK. Although I was double vaxxed, and now, that doesn't even matter. It doesn't matter that you're double vaxxed anymore, because you still have to go and have whatever, you have to pay for the extra test now. Kichiwawa, thank you, Shiv. She is called Lolly. Is it snowing there? What, in Spain? No, it's really warm, like Pacific, it's so nice. I went for a dog, well, I didn't go for a dog walk, I had to take my dog to the vet and they were closed. But I then like walked along the beach because I was like, I'm gonna make the most of it. And it was just so peaceful. I love the ocean. I'm such a water baby, but I feel, I don't know, does anybody else, like when they're near the ocean or like water, I don't know, I feel connected to water. Oh my God, I actually sound like such a hippie right now. Connected to water, but I don't know, there's just something about being near water. I just love it. But I think it's snowing in England. Oh well, when I was at Winter Wonderland, actually, guys, it was started to snow in England. My name is Jose. Hey Jose, how are you doing? Stay in Spain, no pain. The thing is though, like, I think I'm enjoying being back in Spain at the moment because obviously I've just gotten back. But after a while, I do start to go a little bit crazy. Do you have dual citizenship? No, I have residency. So residency was actually really hard to get, guys. But well, it's usually quite hard to get. But because I'm under 25, my parents could like sort it quite well for me, because in Spain, if you're under 25, you're still considered like a child, like you're in your parents' care, if that makes sense. It's very different to England. But because of that, I got my residency quite easy because my parents have been out in Spain for years. So that's really handy, actually. So yeah, I can be in Spain or like any like Spanish island or whatever for as long as possible. I don't have to worry about that. Check my Twitter. Freeze! I don't have Twitter. Actually, so I was researching NFTs the other day, guys, and I created a Twitter account, but I don't. Although I do think I've got I don't think I should say this. Oh well, I'm gonna say it. If anyone can find it, I give it to you. But I do have like a very old Twitter account, I think, that I never deleted, and it's got proper old, like cringe-worthy photos. I also found an old Instagram account, and I don't know how to get into it. And guys, these photos are so bad. I know someone's gonna go find them now. England weather is all over the gaff. England weather, although to be fair, English weather recently has been really not, like, I think English weather's nice when it's blue skies and like cold. Like, I really like that this time of year. It's just like the grey and the getting dark early. But yeah, I'll literally leave the house in England and then suddenly you need like 10,000 layers, especially if you're travelling around London, because once you get in the tube it's hot, when you come out the tube it's freezing. There's no point doing your hair because your hair gets ruined. All the struggles. Whereabouts in Spain? Miles, so I'm actually in Malaga. So that's where I was brought up. And where my parents live. And then I went back to England for basically studying and stuff. And I've sort of been in England ever since. There's a number of matrix showing. Oh, freeze, that's cool. Are you into crypto as well? Yeah, is it GamerX? GamerX? Yeah, I am into crypto. A little bit of crypto. I mean, it's all a guessing, well, it's not all a guessing game, but yeah, I have invested in it. I like to try and I find things like that interesting. So I do want to invest more. Spanish here, where in Spain do you live? Hey, soy, I rock a mommy. Soy rock a mommy? So it's I rock a mommy, right? Can I send you a picture of what I did yesterday? Yes, free. Send it over on the Discord. Suck your munda, little sket. The Masked Jojo, thank you so much for that lovely message.
Reboot the Matrix. Gonna be shown all of a sudden the Matrix game at PS5.
Guys, I can't be listening to Christmas songs right now. I do love Christmas, but I want to put that song on before again. I really like it. I literally had Bob Marley blaring this morning, guys, whilst cooking my breakfast. I love a bit of Bob Marley in the morning.
He invested... nice, always...
Ah, Soy Rock and Mummy, thanks for the follow. Guys, if you're not, please drop me a follow.
Guys, I've always gone to
Elveria. Miles, I feel like I know Elveria. Best place in the world, around Malaga. Elveria, I've heard of it. Is it sort of Marbella way? I haven't played Matrix games since like 2002. Hey, Claus, nice seeing you here. Guys, I actually don't like saying this on stream, but I'm just gonna be honest. Like, well, I'm always honest, but I even from a young age didn't play games. Like Alice, like they'll talk about games that they used to play when they were younger. I don't actually know what I did with my free time. I think I played outside. Like I'm proper old school kid. Like I don't even know. Like, you know, even things, the only things I can remember, like I didn't even play Sims. Like everyone played Sims. I don't understand what I was doing with my time. And now I'm like, This really could have helped me out playing games, because obviously I'm now on Twitch. I don't know how I ended up here. I love chatting on it, but obviously like everyone games. I need to game. I need to learn to game, but ugh. You need to get Monster Destroy. I know none of my mods are in here today, but it's fine. He can. Yeah, Marbella. I thought so. Past Romolina's. Okay, yeah, so I'm literally like the other side. But I do love Marbella and all up that end. That's a lot more buzzy. Like where I am is very like countryside. God's Waiting. What's it called? God's Waiting area corner. God's Waiting Room, that's the one. Yeah, it's nice to come back for some chill time, but I wouldn't want to live here like full time. But at the moment it's really nice because I'm going to different places, so it's fine. We can celebrate the new year with this game. Guys, what's people's new year's plans? Tell me. Nice lamps. Johnny, I love that you noticed these lamps. I actually love these lamps as well. I'm trying to think where they were from. I think they were Zara. Zara Home maybe. I do love a bit of Zara Home. You can't go wrong with it. Best way to be outdoors is the place to be. Yeah, so my dad had a bicycle like repair shop growing up. So we do like a lot of like long bicycle rides. He would bring like all cool like new gadgets home as well. Like I remember there was like this go-kart. They'd like sit on the go-kart. I don't know if anyone else had these or if they actually like took off, but like you'd sit on the go-karts and like ride them. We had like electric scooter, like we had all the new technology, but it wasn't Twitch technology. That's not what I needed. Bob Marley, honestly, whenever, guys, a little life hack that I've learned, and I'd love to, if it helps just one person, it'll make me happy, but I didn't actually realize the power of music. And if I'm ever like really, really, like really sad, and I need to like, I don't know what to do, like honestly, like just in a very bad place, put on some happy music and just dance. Or you don't even have to dance, but just put it on. And honestly, it makes you so happy. But Bob Marley for me is one of them. But obviously everyone's different what makes them happy, like music wise. But yeah, I always say, I think starting the day with Bob Marley as well. But I read that somewhere that they said like a great way to start the day is like listening to songs that you just know are just going to make you happy. I didn't play Sims. Yeah, I didn't play Sims. Does anyone remember Club Penguin? I feel like I did play Club Penguin. But I remember even getting like Nintendo DS. Like, you know, I would honestly, and you'd have like the, everyone played, well, I don't know if it was just girls, but the pet one, Nintendogs. I played it for like 2 minutes and gave up. Like I was awful. I just don't think gaming's been in my soul. Although I remember, actually, I did love Mario Kart on Wii. Mario Kart on Wii was a bit of me. Do you have any console? No, I don't, but my brother does. So my brother is on Twitch and he streams Fortnite. But I don't know, Fortnite doesn't really interest me, but I do have stuff. It's going to be Fallen. Oh, it's okay. It's nice and comfy here. Game at your own pace. Everyone their own stuff. Maybe you're just a weekend warrior and not a hardcore gamer. I do need to give it a go though, don't I? Jack, thank you so much for the follow. Yeah, I think you're right. But I don't know. Part of me is like, it would be quite funny to like stream it on Twitch, me learning this game. But at the same time, I can't promise what's going to come out, guys, because I'm not very patient. I'm not a patient soul. And I feel like with gaming, you need to be a patient soul. But I literally, when I was at the Lost House, I literally just had the remote and they were like, I didn't even know what like buttons was like enter or anything like that. I was so confused by like the consoles. Like, I'm really bad. What could we be celebrating? Guys, Question. What's people's thoughts on, like, New Year's resolutions? Like, do you make New Year's resolutions? Have you ever stuck to New Year's resolutions? Have you got a New Year's resolution? Because I'd love to know. Yeah, I always hear some Imagine Dragons before my exams. Imagine Dragons. I'm trying to think. What's their like well-known? Oh, it's That's so cool though, Pacific, that you did that. I'm trying to think. Oh, what's the Imagine Dragons song that's like well-known? I'm trying to think it. Gaming causes grey hairs. Well, I definitely don't want them, Craig. So maybe I'll stick away. We don't need no grey hair. My mum's actually like, I'm trying to think how old she is now, like 56, and she doesn't have any grey hairs. Believer, I'm gonna put it on. Is it? Because I remember really liking Imagine Dragons. Uber Norman, thank you so much for the follow, guys. I've actually got something really funny to tell you about Uber. Wait. Believer. I'm trying to think. Lost John A. I know who you are. Hey babe, how are you? Yes. Ooh. 56, same age. Same as your age. Yes, I am 56. Captro, thank you so much for the follow. But yeah, guys, so I did a little, should we call it a social experiment? So you know with Uber, you can add like your own picture into Uber. So anyway, I kept getting cancelled on, and my friends did as well after like an event, because everyone was trying to get Ubers at the same time. So I was like, do you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put a really fit picture as my Uber picture. I was like, because, I don't know, we might as well just give it a go. And actually people now were like, that's actually really dangerous. So I was like, that's actually true. However, your girl got picked up, like literally straight away. And me and my friends were literally dying because we've been sat there for like an hour trying to get an Uber. No Ubers would pick us up. They kept cancelling last minute. I changed my Uber picture, like my actually put, because I didn't have one on before. And they turned up. So my message for you guys, if you're ever in a stage where you're not getting picked up on Uber, just catfish the Uber driver. Like, even if you don't want to put your own picture up, just get a picture off the internet and put it on and catfish your Uber driver. That is my message to you. Kedis TV, thank you so much for the follow. Guys, we're getting closer to that 6K and I'm so excited. Oh, you must have heard Demons. Let me try Demons. I know Believer. I do know this one specific. I feel like there's another one though. I feel like there's definitely another one. They deliver pizzas. I don't eat pizza anymore. Catfish Uber drivers, a pickup of you younger than 56. You are very beautiful. Jay Montero, how are you today? I don't think that will work, Red Deb. I mean, I don't know. Who knows? Give it a go. I guess it depends on the Uber driver's beliefs. But yeah, that was just my experience. I couldn't believe it happened. You stopped yesterday. So I've actually got a really sad story. So I became, just before lockdown, I became vegan. Oh yeah, no, I think this is it, Pacific. I think it is Demons. I know this one, Thunder. Let me hear it. Pacific, you love a bit of Imagine Dragons, don't you? Wait. Thunder. No. But yeah, they're all like very feel-good songs, aren't they? So yeah, I became vegan. Well, actually, no. It's a pescatarian, but cut out dairy just before lockdown. So it's been like a year. And then I've come back to England and I was like, screw it, I miss cheese. I'm going to have pizza. I'm going to have chocolate, like dairy milk chocolate. Like I ate quite a lot. I've come up with rashes, like literally rashes all over my body. They're all under my armpit, like they're so sore. And basically I think it's dairy. So yeah, I actually did stop eating pizza yesterday, to be fair, Uber Norman, like that is actually true. But yeah, I can't eat it anymore, which is really sad. Can you live with a ball for that New Year celebration? Oh, freeze! I'm gonna be. What am I doing for New Year's? I'm gonna be with friends for New Year's. I don't know if I'll be. Well, I could stream a little bit, to be fair. How sad. Sad. They kept me from failing my test. That's amazing. I love how with music, like, you'll have different songs that, like, connect you to. I don't know, like, you'll listen to songs and they'll bring you back to, like, different memories. I love that. Hello, JR. How are you today? It's so bad for us to stay away. Oh. Honestly, I'm very upset. And also, Christmas is around the corner, but I think I'm going to have to literally stay away from, like, any dairy, which is actually heartbroken because I'm actually, what's the most thing that I'm going to miss? To be fair, it's not cheese or anything like that. It's chocolate, like dairy milk chocolate. Like, you know, the boxes of Celebrations and the boxes of like Quality Street and the boxes of Heroes. Do you guys eat them? We used to, like, as a family of, well, it's basically three. Cause Dad doesn't really eat chocolate. Like a family of three, we'd go through like so many boxes every day. On the approaching Christmas. Breathe. Da, da, da. Try this song, Running Up the Hill. Who's it by? It's weird actually, because I think Craig, like, the more you, it's like, I think where I hadn't had them, I hadn't craved chocolate or anything. Like, I wasn't even that bothered, I just started eating them. And now that I've had them, like, my body is just craving, like, sugar and all that good stuff. But I'm on a massive health kick. Basically, got charged extra from my luggage, even though it was the same price. Took so long to drop my bag off that I had to run through the airport. The guy made me think that I was going to miss my flight. To then get to the desk, not had any food or anything, get to the desk, and they were literally like, I can't really concentrate. And it was roped off. Thought I'd missed my flight. Turned out they hadn't even boarded and the plane was late and wasn't there. It was just a very big stress. There was a lot that went on. Oh yeah, when I went to pay for my bag, wouldn't take Apple Pay. So I had to open up my case to try and find my card. But my card was actually hidden in my suitcase somewhere. And the guy was so rude. Honestly, he was so rude. I've never had such bad customer service before. Yep, stay away from the Red Bulls. Craig, I am so addicted to Red Bull. I've never even liked Red Bull before, guys. I don't know, is anyone else like this? I don't really know, but I never had Red Bull before. Literally, this trip back from London, so last Saturday, Saturday before, first time I've ever enjoyed a Red Bull. I can't stay away, guys. I'm literally sat here, my friend's coming round later, and I'm literally wanting her to, stopping myself from texting her, can you bring me a Red Bull? Because I can't have a Red Bull that late, because otherwise I literally can't sleep. Hey, Kimoz, how are you? Yeepers, good morning. Hey, Trifax, good morning to you. How you doing? Nice Instagram for you to too hot. Guys, if you haven't, please drop me a follow on Instagram. So Tiggs, the IG post. There we go, guys. If you're not following on Instagram, you're going to need to follow on Instagram because the post. Guys, I know that was a good one. I was actually a bit nervous to post that, though. Ask you stuff, Bet. Can I get your number? I'll think about it. This song by Tebow, Running Up the Hill. Okay, Freeze, let me put that on for you. I don't think I'd be able to see you, to be honest. I'd be able to see you today, to be honest. It's been quite busy. Oh, really? You mean on stream? I was so confused then, I wasn't even concentrated. What is it, being busy with work? That's a can of drugs right there. Craig, I know. I need to stop because I'm also coffee. I used to drink 8 cups of coffee a day. You guys should have seen me. Did any of you see me in Millie's stream? It was basically a Tiggy takeover on Millie's stream. It was really funny. And everyone kept coming in thinking I was Millie. And then I wrote on a whiteboard, this is not Millie. Guys, I was so hyper. I know I'm quite hyper anyway. I feel like I usually do have quite a bit of energy. But I was so hyper on that stream from the Red Bull. You're helping my friend is kind of helping my friend is designed for listening section because your accent is clean and easy to understand, so I recommended her to tune into your stream. Oh, do you think it's quite easy to understand? Thanks. I'm glad I can help. What is the IELTS exam, so Pacific? Tigga, Cash Monday, how are you today? It ends up being a 5-day thing. Yeah, it's actually really bad. I don't think I'd let myself get to 5 a day.
I love you, Tiggy, so much. XOXO Zuck Socks.
Oh, Freeze! Love you, thank you so much for that lovely donation. I love it as well because we now have text to speech for everything. We have it for the donos, we have it for the bits. It makes me so happy. Thank you so, so much, Freeze. That means a lot. Appreciate it. Good song choice, by the way. Just because you've got to work with Xmas planning. Guys, who's done Christmas shopping? Because your girl's a little overwhelmed. Actually, I listened to a podcast this morning, guys. If you haven't, and I don't know, if you're into I'm very much into psychology and how the brain works. I find it very interesting, how people's emotions, and I'm a bit of a a nerd when it comes to that sort of thing. So I like reading like podcasts and listening to books. No, listening to podcasts, reading books, not reading podcasts, listening to books. That doesn't make sense. But anyway, one of the podcasts that I read this morning, listened to this morning, I shared it on my Instagram and it's really, really good. But basically, apparently if you say the word overwhelmed, it makes you feel overwhelmed. And then it's too much. You have to say the word stressed, not overwhelmed. But I am so stressed because I literally haven't ordered any Christmas presents yet. And usually I do it on Black Friday. And I don't know why I didn't do it on Black Friday, because I'm so annoyed at myself. Because everything I want to buy now is like double the price again. I could have literally saved so much money. But yeah, has anyone done their Christmas shopping? And what planning do you have username to do? Coffee does nothing to me either. Does energy drink? Unfortunately, worst player, apparently, if that's the case. I only know this because my friend was writing about it the other day. She's always thought that she has ADHD and she's got like loads of different symptoms, but she's never been tested for it. And she put on her story that like energy drinks and like pre-workout and things like that don't work for her. And apparently that is because she has ADHD. The alerts seem a little low. I know, I've just turned up the volume, sorry. I know, they were a little low. When I gifted my bit. Yeah, I know, username. Yeah, I always forget to turn my volume up, but it's at full length now. It's a mandatory English test that you have to take if you like to study in the UK. Oh, wow. Okay, that's really cool. I have ADHD. There we go. Just been living. Have you been tested and everything? How do you take like medication? I've been living in 3 hours sleep every night for the last 6 months, maybe longer. 3 hours sleep. I don't know how people do that. I just love sleep, guys. Like, I actually just love sleep. I couldn't not have, like, I'm trying to actually have less sleep because I have been having too much, not too much recently, but when I'm here, I think I end up oversleeping. It's to do with shopping and arranging commitments for people to come around. It's to do with shopping and arranging commitments for people to come round, meaning if it's safe to do so. What, coming round yours? Nah, no medication, to be honest. Lack of sleep has killed the ADHD. Got no energy. Oh, wow. So do you think that's, like, do you feel okay though? But then having no energy doesn't sound that great either. Pacific, well, me being here, I literally work out, sleep. Because I don't go out. I have I don't really have any social life. Well, I've got like one friend. I have decided I need to start making more effort and going out around this area. I'm gonna put, where is it? Sorry guys, bear with me. What was the thing I was just listening to? Oh, we'll put a bit of Justin on. Guys, did any of you do your year wrap on Spotify? Holidays must be nice. My work has refused all holidays from December the 1st. Oh no. Yeah, that's what my cousin was actually. So I had like a family reunion recently and I was with my cousin and he's just changed job and he said it's the first year since, because he's always been at the same job since he left school, and it's the first year like literally since he's left school that he's got time off over Christmas. Because he's allowed to take time off, but that is annoying that you can't take any time off over the holidays. No, booking a place to stay. Oh, where are you staying? work Boxing Day at 4 a.m. to 6 p.m. Too nice. I love it. Working Boxing Day at 4 a.m. till 6 p.m. You love it. Worst play. Are you being sarcastic? Hello, Ash. How are you? You've flown yet? Digital. I have flown. It was a bloody... Honestly, I travel a lot. And I've never, in my whole travelling experience, experienced a flight like I did on Sunday evening. Honestly, it was quite traumatic. Well, it wasn't traumatic. Okay, that's... I am a bit of a drama queen, guys. It wasn't that bad. But it was bad. sometimes you get two in one. She'll work out and stream through. Takes ages to start working out. Yeah, sometimes I will work out and stream. I'm actually starting to run again as well. So I'm waiting for my body to crash because I'm eating less, working out more, which is gonna result in good results, but I'm waiting for the body to crash. Tiggy having a hard time. Pacific, it's not that I have a hard time having friends. It's that, not that I don't get along with the people around here. How do I explain it? Everyone who I was friends with have left this area because it's very like, very chill, very countryside, quite like small-minded, quite a slow pace. So everyone who I was friends with when I was here have gone off to either study or find work somewhere. It's not really the place that you stay to sort of build a life, you know? Everyone sort of leaves here. So the people that are left here, I don't know how to say it without literally sounding like a bitch. It's not that I don't want to socialise with them. I just feel like we don't have anything in common. I'm very much like excited by the world, want to travel, want to see things, want to experience different things. I'm very spontaneous. And the people, not everyone, but like a lot of people that are still left here aren't. I feel like they're almost just a bit, and I'm a bit, woo, and they're a bit, that's the only way I can explain it. So I don't tend to go out when I'm here, and if I am here, I'd rather socialise with my family. Anyway, love the OO Infinity. Ah, thanks, Freeze. Yes, very sarcastic. Yeah, worst player. That's nasty. But at least you're not working like Boxing, Christmas Eve and Christmas. Hello from New York, Tiggy. Hello. Oh, I would love to be in New York right now, Jimmy. I'm very jealous. Yeah, the Cockney accent. Jimmy, do you think I've got a Cockney accent? How can you tell? If you're American, how can you tell? It's not the hard times. It's not that I have a hard time making them. It's just I have a hard time making them. are they intimidated by you? I don't know. I don't think so. I don't think that I'm intimidating. I don't think that I'm intimidating, but... Oh my God! Aaliyah, thank you so much for the raid! Welcome, raiders! Oh, this is my second raid of you. Thank you so much, babe. How are you doing today? And hello, everybody! Thank you so much for the follows. Did you have a good stream? Good evening, Link. Yo, hey X2 Gamer. Hello, HD Gamer. Good evening, Link. It's it's actually, what time is it here? I'm in Spain right now, so it's currently like 3:43 p.m. Wait, you don't have a Cockney accent, don't you? Mikey! Oh my God, the second month of our reset. Thank you so much for subbing, Mikey, and the second month as well. That means a lot. That means you've stuck around for 2 whole months. I really appreciate it. Thank you. How are you today? Hello, Royo. Good time in drinking. Also, pretty girls is intimidating. Lincoln, I don't know. I don't think I give off an intimidating personality. I don't know. Do you guys think I give off an intimidating personality? Aaliyah's one of the best Aussie streamers around. She's also gorgeous. Thank you so much. Honestly, I really appreciate it. How is it in Australia? Yeah, same time as me, 3:43. Oh, where are you, Link? It's 1:40 a.m. in Melbourne. Ooh, X2 Gamer, you're up late. Blue! Sorry, my dog's barking. 3:43. Oh, is it? This, where are you from? Hello, how are you doing? Digital. I'm fab. I'm really good. How are you today? I got you. It's hard, random situation. Watching your face. Hope you're well. How's Spain? It's good. I literally got back here yesterday. It's nice to be back. Honestly, I've actually decided, guys, I can't deal with England weather anymore. Like, it's dark by 4 p.m. By the time it's 7 p.m., I'm literally ready for bed. I'm ready to sleep. Like, I mentally think it's like 10 p.m. I come back to Spain and it's still like, it doesn't get dark now until about 6:30. I can deal with that. It's warm. It's actually such nice weather today. If you guys look on my story on Instagram, I literally posted the beach today was beautiful. I'm good, off to work, so just chilling, Mikey. I love that. Come chill with me. I'm just chilling today as well. 6:43 in California. 6:43 a.m. Yeah, you guys are behind. Time zones are really weird, guys. I still haven't wrapped my head around time zones. HD Gamer, thank you so much. Don't stalk her playing like this in your life. Call of Duty reality. Good and dark. Low. Personality, I can't say. But generally, pretty girls are intimidating. Oh, do you think? I don't know. I don't know if I'm intimidating or not. I like to think I'm not, but I think you can meet girls. I do get that, and you can. I do get some girls can be intimidating. But I think when I meet people, I'm always quite. Actually, no, that's a lie. I was gonna say I'm quite friendly, but sometimes I'm really not. It depends on the mood. Usually I am, but sometimes no. Netherlands. In Netherlands, does it get quite dark quite early as well? I've got a hard, random people situation, washing your face at the toilet restaurant. And stalking you. Wait, what? How is your trip back to Spain? Guys, my trip back to Spain was actually the worst. I've travelled quite a lot, and honestly, the plane journey from England to Spain this time is actually the worst journey I've ever had, like, in my life. Hence why I didn't stream yesterday, guys. I usually stream on a Monday. I was literally dead to the world. Yeah, England weather's... Oh, Aaliyah, I can't deal with it. Honestly, I am actually thinking, because obviously it's got to the stage where... So I'm in Spain at the moment, but I don't want to stay in Spain, at least not this area. I haven't been, but I'm literally, like, Australia shouting my name. So I've actually got family in Melbourne. But I'd really like to just have experience Australia because, yeah, I don't know where I want to live, but it's not England and it's not Spain, so I need to visit some countries and work it out. I feel the same about New Jersey. I want to move to Florida. Randall, honestly, I've never visited the USA, so I'm actually not that well traveled at all, guys. And Florida is one of the places I want to move to, like, well, not move to, but visit. Like, it looks so lovely. Do you like teddy bears? I do. I won a teddy bear at Winter Wonderland, guys, and I was so excited. But what was it? It was like a Dumbo. And I called it Penguin because I told everyone on stream that I was going to win a penguin. And I didn't. So I ended up calling Dumbo Penguin. But I ended up leaving it with my auntie's dog because my auntie's dog loved Dumbo. I'll jump on a plane now. So what's up? Hey, Sebastian. Are you having coffee on the beach by any chance? Used to live in Germany. It was the same. Are these going to do justice? Username. The booty is still growing. We're getting there. England is windy today. We lost a tree. Oh, I don't like wind either. Wind actually can make people crazy. There's this island. Well, not an island. But this area off of Spain. in Spain, sorry, and it's so windy, like it's crazy. It has like one of the most highest suicide rates because the wind actually drives people crazy. Honestly. So you play any games? HD Gamer, I was actually having a chat about this earlier. I don't. I'm so sorry, I know. I don't know why I'm on Twitch. I don't know how I ended up on Twitch. But we've been talking about like when I was younger and like I was chatting to like some of the girls and stuff about games we used to play. I've never played any games. Like, I was like, I don't know what I was doing with my youth. Like, I don't know. I was outside riding bikes, but I do want to get into gaming though. I've got to go because I'm so damn tired. Have a one. Oh, Aaliyah, thank you so much, babe. Catch you later, guys, on my side as well. If you haven't dropped Aaliyah a follow because she's lovely. Thank you so, so much. Bye, HD Gamer. Thanks for sticking around. Hello, Kenneth. How are you? Ciao, Paranoid. Thank you, Adam, for that lovely comment. Come to Hawaii. Yeah, so Hawaii does look really, really cool too, actually. I really want to visit Hawaii. That's on my list. California's ready. Pacific California sounds cool too. There's so many places I want to visit, and there's just, it's not even time, it's money, isn't it? Let's be honest. Like, all these traveling to all these places, but hopefully, eventually, someday. green tea. Sebastian, you're not having a coffee today. I wish I'd buy a tea for you, your Amazon address. I know, I need an Amazon wish list really freeze. Do the easy stuff. Do you reckon digital? So, yeah, if I was to start a game, guys, bearing in mind I have no patience. No patience. What would you say I should start gaming? Cali is very expensive to live. Yeah, I mean, Randall, so is like where I'm from in England, like London is so, it's crazy pricing, like, it's mad. It's actually crazy. Like, the amount you pay for literal shitholes is laughable. It's actually laughable. Like, I don't think I'd ever buy, like, in London unless I was, like, a billionaire. Which I might be, guys. You never know. Crypto, NFTs. Watch this space. Hawaii, is it? But do you have areas that aren't so expensive? Hey, Dake, how are you? Oh, Daryl, hello, hello. How are you today? Hopefully, eventually, someday, indeed. Hopefully, eventually, someday, finally. I need to keep that going. You do ICA delivery. You do, I could deliver your wish list. Okay, guys, I am gonna create a wish list. I don't even know how does it even work? Would you like to game that's like a movie, but choices you make change the way the rest of the story goes? Would you like a game that's like a movie, but the choices you make change in the way the rest of the story goes? Link, that actually does sound quite good. What game is that? Mario Kart, digital. I used to love Mario Kart on Wii. Can you play it on different things, guys? Right, you have to imagine, okay, when you're explaining gaming to me, I'm like an alien from outer space, and I come to Earth, and I'm like, so what's this? This is me when we talk about gaming, guys. Take care. Bye, Freeze. Thank you so much for your lovely donation as well, babe. I'll catch you soon. Where's the next sleep stream? Oh my gosh, true. God, well, would you guys be interested in another sleep stream? Because they are quite funny. I mean, I would be up for doing another sleep stream again, guys, to be fair. They are funny. I just, I don't know. Is that something people want to see? Oh, Daryl! Thank you so, so much for giving us up. Oh, and Sebastian, we got it! Hot tub. Sebastian, I did do a hot tub stream not too long ago, to be fair. Thank you so much, Daryl. I really appreciate that. That's so lovely. You want a new surfboard for Christmas. Oh, that's cute. What am I getting for Christmas? Oh, I got a necklace. I got a necklace coming my way. Games like Heavy Rain, Detroit Human. I like that. Link. I need to have a look like that. But that sounds really cool. What's the difference between an Xbox and PS? Like, how do you know which one to have? I think my brother's got a PS. So I'd probably just use his, to be fair, to start gaming. Most likely. Hey girl, looking good. That's an emphasis on the good. Thanks, Mark. How are you today? I'm drinking my coffee. Guys, I always make a coffee at the beginning of stream, right? And it's like an hour in and I still haven't drunk my coffee. And then I complain that my coffee goes cold. Detroit become human. They made the characters do the voice and look like the people that do the voice, like almost identical. Wait, so is it actually real people, like real like celebrities or something? Is that what you mean? So it'd be like well-known people. Guys, surprisingly enough, Justin Bieber was in my top four, my Spotify playlist. Love it more when you don't tie your hair up, but it looks pretty too. Oh, Pacific, I know, but the thing is, my hair at the moment, sheesh, that's such a cool emote. Is that snow? I've actually got a hair mask in right now. So it's better not to put any heat on my hair. When I have it down, I have to put heat on it. So when I'm just here and chilling, I tend to wear my hair like this just because it's better for my hair. But yeah, I know. I prefer my hair down too. No, it's a game, but the characters in the game, they look like people that do the voices. Sorry, that last song was bad. No, it's a game, but the characters in the game, they look like the people that do the voices. Okay, well maybe I need to give this a go. This is the first time I've heard of this game, but it sounds interesting. Mario Kart is a good way of getting to know the console controller. Yeah, digital, I know that I enjoyed Mario Kart as well. So maybe Mario Kart is where it needs to be at. Yeah, well, snow, not everyone gets snow. It's because I knew it's the time of year. You should play some games as top streamers. Join the meta. You should play some game as top streamers. Join the meta if understand. Wait, what do you mean, Koi? Did you... It snows in Hawaii. What? What? This is news to me. Does it actually? Sorma, thank you so much for the follow. Just play FIFA and only score with Ronaldo. Yeah, I mean, no, I don't really like football either, so I don't think football's a good one for me. I can barely kick a ball anyway. I'm actually awful at football, like really, really bad. Yeah, it snowed in Hawaii. The first bit, are you from Hawaii as well? It don't snow in Hawaii. Oh, am I? Guys, I'm so gullible. Dan. Oh my God, I actually love that username. Dan, da, 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 Dan, Dan. Thank you for the follow. Koi, I don't really agree. People should play what fits them, in my opinion. Oh, so he's saying play more like popular games. Is this what you mean? Hey Juma, how are you today? Flex the bicep, Tiggy. Pacific, we don't have any biceps at the moment. They're pending. My biceps are in construction. Haven't had the highest rainfall index. Wow. Haven't has the highest rainfall. Wow. Is haven't in Hawaii? Like saying snowing in Florida, which never happens. Oh, I don't know. To be fair, it's actually snowed in Spain before, but there was actually snow on the beach near me, and that's so rare. So I believe it, because I just think, let's be honest, guys, like, the weather's going a bit crazy at the moment, and it has been for a little while. I feel like people enjoy laughing at the apocalypse. It's okay, we need humour before it all ends. Do you believe there's going to be an apocalypse? What are we talking, like a zombie apocalypse? Any footballers you find attractive? Merck. No. I mean, I'm sure there are, but none that can stick out for me. But I'd never want to be a wag. Not that there's anything wrong with being a wag. Pig is step sis sayers. Lol. What does that mean, Kenny? Ah, Jim, thank you so much for the follow. Nah, work in progress. Okay. They're a work in progress. They're getting, well, I'm starting to get back into the gym again, guys. Come back to me in 3 weeks' time. hello, gaming. She on her way back today. Right, she's good. I spoke to her yesterday, actually. We got some photos back from the photo shoot, so we just need to go through them and pick the ones that we like. But she's good, I believe. I don't know when she's back, though. But yeah, it is around now, I think. Laughing at the snow in Hawaii is like at fires, and they're not too far apart. They see very different results of weather. Wait, Kenneth, you're confusing me. Not that it takes much to confuse me, but I'm getting confused. Well, Tiki, I can send you what the characters look like. And their voiceovers looks like that. So David Beckham. Ah, Link, please do. Please do. So David, okay, to be fair, Link, you have got me there. David Beckham, I think younger David Beckham. Yeah, I can see it. I don't think him now as much, but yeah, when he was like younger, definitely. honestly, Tiggy usually gets like changed to turban, like I find a lot of the time. With like autocorrect digits, or it's so annoying. Surely young Ronaldo was the guy, not gonna lie, he's handsome day. I don't think Ronaldo did it for me, you know, I don't know why. How do you find Spanish gyms in comparison to gyms back in London? Again, Pacific. So I think it depends what gym you go to. Like the gyms around here that I've been to aren't that great. They're quite like basic. But again, it's because I live like in a very small town, quite like countryside area. So yeah, the gyms are like not as extended. But I've also been to some shocking gyms in England. Like one of the gyms that I signed up to not too long ago in London, oh my god, like you would go and like the mats would have been like completely destroyed, like literally had like holes in the mats, like it was a joke, and literally nothing. I'm going to send it 100% to the UK. I'm often banned for this. You live on Martha. No ideas. I'm so gullible. Yo, hello Chetan, how are you? Okay, such a posh girl. It's so weird because people come in and they're like, oh my gosh, you're so posh, or they're like, oh my gosh, you have such a Cockney accent, and I'm just like, I don't know what I am. I don't know. Where would you like the side by side? Oh, do you mean what sent it to me? If you send it to me Do you have my Insta? I'll link it. In case you want to have a little look, have a great day, rest of your day. Time to make food and get some exercise. Love that. Catch you later, Gaming Redemption. Thanks for popping in. And Tig's getting her abs on, Kenneth. Yeah, your girl gets put on a little bit of extra chub. So, yeah, we need to lose that. I say this is American. Dear posh girls. Gaining Redemption, thanks so much for the follow as well. Catch you soon. A better question. Who is your celebrity crush then? I have to really think about this one because my, what's it called? Brain. No, that's not the right words. What's the words? My opinion. Is it opinion? Changes like the wind. Guys, I don't know why none of my words are coming out today. But like, it always changes. Like, some days I'll be like, oh, I like a bit of Justin Bieber. And then I'm like, oh, love a bit of like Harry Styles. And then I'm like, oh, love a bit of like Ryan Reynolds, which isn't, I don't know. There's a lot. I couldn't pick one. I'll take them all. I can tell you aliens live with us. You will believe me. I actually do believe there's aliens. Well, no. Let me say that again. I don't believe that. I don't believe there's aliens is like what we're led to believe are aliens. But I do believe that if the world is like never end, is infinite, like they say. I just don't believe that we're the only living, like, creatures. That's my opinion. Bye-bye, bye-bye. You're getting your toes out for the lads or nah? Theoretical, PayPal me. I'll see what I can do. She is trying to think of him. Life's a peach, eh, Mikey? Life's a peach. Rainbow, oh, Kenneth, I get them all the time. Especially when I'm chatting because my brain works faster than, like, what comes out of my mouth. And I have such bad memory. This is why I talk so fast, guys, because I know if I don't get it out of my head, I will forget it. So, but, like, a lot of the time, I just forget what I'm saying. But that's also bad because when I'm streaming as well, I literally say what I think. And obviously, sometimes you have to think about what you say. Hello, do you believe in God? We are not alone. Hello, Bo. So, I'm actually from quite a religious background. I'm sort of here. Have you ever visited Barcelona and how did you find it? I went in the summer. I love Barcelona. So I've only visited Barcelona though for like doctor's appointments. So I haven't actually been like on a holiday there. However, Barcelona is one of my favorite cities that I've been to. I just think the culture is mad and the just like, you'd walk around and like the music, everything. I just loved it. And the way it's such a major town, like city, and it's like on the beach. I honestly, guys, yeah, I love it. Did you like it, Matt? I love Scarlett Johansson. Ah, Kenneth, nice choice. And Jennifer Lawrence, really? Okay. Yeah, both gorgeous. So if you think living things on Earth are the only living things in the universe, you're just in denial. Yeah, I very much agree with that, Linka. It's just a matter of time that are we gonna meet, like, but then also I don't know what I expect, but I doubt it's like anything like us. I don't know, but then I doubt it's anything like we see like in movies and things. But it's very interesting. How's let me allow that. I'm so sorry. I
So sorry, I sent it on Insta, but I don't think it made it clickable. Oh
no, really? Send it on here then, Link. I'll have a look. She'd rather believe in aliens than mad. I'm a very open-minded person. How's the Xmas tree, by the way? Does Santa still suck? Pacific, I'm going to have to explain that comment now because that comment just doesn't... People in chat right now are going to be like, what the hell? So, my family, instead of like an angel on the top of the Christmas tree, we have this Father Christmas. We've always had him. He's quite old. But to stick him on the tree... He basically has a hole up his bum. And the issue is, so I actually did a stream, guys, putting up my Christmas decorations and stuff. And when I was on stream, we realised that Father Christmas's bum hole had gotten too loose. So Dad had to try and fix Father Christmas's bum hole so it would fit on the tree, because after all the years of sitting on the tree, the hole was too big. So, so yeah, he's now back on. He's very happy on the tree. He fits very nicely on the tree.
Dude, some people are impossible.
Bossa, thank you for the follow.
Are you able to elbows touch? The beaches or a legendary in Barcelona, girl? Another.
Oh, I didn't actually go to the beaches. Like, I saw the Merc, but I. I just clicked my finger. Guys. I'd never been able to click my fingers before, and one just clicked. Exciting.
Hey.
You seem fun. I'd date you in a minute. Oh, Kenneth, why, thank you. You are open-minded, gullible. Love it when Tiki explains.
If you see it, is all you don't see.
If what you see is all you see, then you do not see all that is to be seen.
I agree. Bo, I agree.
I am very open-minded. I love listening to other people's opinions as well when they are not forced upon you, because sometimes opinions can be forced upon you. That sometimes rubs me up the wrong way, but apart from that, I'm very interested. For example, I don't know if there's any flat earthers in chat, or if you even know what flat earth is, but when I was in Ibiza, there were a lot of flat earthers, which basically, they believe the earth is flat, basically. And I found that very interesting, and I'd ask them about it, you know, I found it quite curious and all of that. But then there was like one person and they'd literally be forcing their views on you, and that's when I switch off. Like, I find it everything very interesting to an extent. I'd be full of, because that's why actually. You do meet I'm not gonna say that theoretical, and I'm not gonna put it that harshly, and I don't believe that either. But there are, yeah, I've met a lot of like interesting people. And I mean, for like there's a different breed. You can't call people breeds. You can't call people breeds, but you know what I mean? Like there's just a lot of different characters. No, Dade, I'm not. Be careful of clicking your dose if it becomes addictive. Yeah, I know. I thought this can it actually cause arthritis? Because apparently that's not actually true, Mark. But then that's my cousin told me that. And he can click literally every part in his body. The thing that bothers me, guys, is the back and neck. Like when people click their back and... Oh. That really creeps me out. The joints click is, which isn't good. I'm trying to stop clicking joints anyway. Just giving you a heads up before. Yeah, I know, Merc, it's true. I need to stop because since being with my cousin, I'm like, oh, can I click things? I'm like, does this click? But actually, I need to stop clicking things. I am very good. Thanks, Sunderland. How are you today? Did I say flat? I meant fat. Earth is fat. Wait, what? Well, I mean, they believe the Earth is flat, and I'm like, good for you. You believe what you want to believe, boo. Like, you do you. I'm so here for it. Like, if people have got different theories or whatever, I love hearing about it. I love, like, I'm very interested in people. Like, you know. But I think there's your opinions, and then there's, like, forcing your opinions. And as soon as it's, like, someone's, like, projecting their opinions onto me, that's when I, like, switch off and don't listen. You got two dogs. Do they get along with each other? Yeah, I do have two dogs. Pacific, yeah, they get along really well, actually. Blue, so I've got a bigger dog as well, guys, who's a rescue. He is very timid, actually. But they do get along really well. They do, when they play fight, it's so funny because she's so tiny and he's so big. But she's the boss. Like, she's so the boss. He's scared of everything. The thing of this world is temporary. Of course it is. Of course. Good. Ah, good, Sunderland. Did you have a nice weekend? Actually, they aren't any pros. Clicking fingers and stuff. Yeah, that's what I thought, Dave. It's just like air pockets, isn't it? McDonald's and Taco Bell's, the gravity of the world. I don't rate Taco Bell. I've had it a couple of times. And another, guys, I feel like I'm about to get some unfollows right now. But another one I don't like is, I don't like Taco Bell and I hate KFC. I don't even really eat chicken now. But like when I did used to eat chicken, I didn't even like it. Are you the boss? You seem dominant, lol. I don't know. Do I come off dominant? I don't know. I don't like being told what to do. But at the same time, I quite like go with the flow kind of person. But I have limits. So I think I am quite easygoing. But I also, when there's a, like, you know when you've pushed my boundaries, you know? When you've taken up my patience, you will know about it. But I think until then, I'm quite easygoing. But I don't know if I'm dominant. I'm not sure. Do I seem dominant? I don't know. I've not had that before. I actually know plenty of people that used to click their knees of years and now got arthritis. Really, maybe the fingers is something else, but knees and neck are very sensitive. Also, the more you crack the joints, they start to crack their daily movement, which is, oh no. So, for arthritis, I don't know if any of you have heard, if any of you suffer from arthritis, my parents actually have, what's it called? It's called like golden paste, which is like turmeric, oil, pepper, like it's disgusting. Smells vile, but my dad really suffered. He had like a major operation in his shoulder. And he really suffered from, he started getting really bad arthritis in it. He's been taking this paste, it's literally completely gone. The same with my mum. And actually, funny enough, yeah, she used to click her knuckles. And she started getting like arthritis in her knuckles. And again, completely gone. So I definitely, if you're starting to or it's something you're worried about, I definitely research it, guys. It's like turmeric, but it's called golden paste, I think. But if you type like turmeric, I'm sure it will come up on the internet. Now Earth is curvy, just like I want my face to be. Pacific, I love that. What, unfollowing Kenneth? I know. I've never rated KFC. Oh, theoretical. I definitely do not eat bacon. Thank you very much. So don't get attached to things of this world. Well, I think, but to be fair, like, by the time the world ends, I mean, I'm going to be gone, aren't I? Let's be honest. But I definitely, if you're talking about like materialistic things and stuff, I definitely believe be attached to what's within, guys. Namaste. You actually seem... But just easy going, like go on Tinder and tell girls what to do. Wait, what? You actually seem, what do you mean easily go, wait, what? I don't understand that, Kenneth. What do you mean? Merkay, thank you so much for the follow. I'm in Paris now, so early for me. You're in Paris now, so it's still early for you. Yeah, won't it be, it'll be 4:19 for you. It's the same time as me, Kenneth. 10% dominant, 30% gullible, 200% pretty. I'm finding my foot feelings true. Specific, you and your lines, I'm loving them. What's something you like about yourself or something you need to work on, Tiggy? Something I like about myself. I'd like to say I'm quite a happy, positive person. And I really like that about myself. Like in bad situations, I always think the good and I'm always quite positive even if things are going wrong. So I say that's something I like about myself. Something I need to work on. I would like to be, I think maybe self-belief, if we're gonna get deep. But yeah, I think I'm always the first person to sort of knock myself. So yeah, I'd say self-belief is something. But if we're talking about like I'm making a New Year's resolution, guys, and my New Year's resolution is actually to just ask for things. So I think there's a saying, if you don't ask, you don't get. And there's a few people in my life at the moment that I've realized they just ask. And like the thing is, if it's a no, it's a no, but you ask, and it's the most simple thing, but I just think that's such a good, like I'm going to start, like if I want something, I'm just going to ask for it, you know? So that's my New Year's resolution. But thanks, Matt. That was such a good question. What about you? I love the creators, his creation. Good. I love my God. That's good. Easy going, like, don't get me wrong with this, like turnover. How tall are you? I'm 5'5" and a half, and the half counts, guys. You're very positive, I agree. I quite like that a lot. It's very difficult and nice personality trait. Thanks, Mark. Yeah, I don't know where the positivity came from. I don't know why. But yeah, I do tend to think about things, and I think it's so important to be positive, because honestly, I think so much that we go through in life is such like a perception. So I listened to this guy. I'm like obsessed with an author called Vex King, and he once said something, and I thought, wow, like that's actually so. So say this, right? You're coming home from work, and your train's been delayed by half an hour. Everyone else is fuming and angry because their train's delayed half an hour. It's half an hour until you get home. He sees it as, well, I'm going to be home in half an hour. How lovely. So you could either sit there moaning and being annoyed and negative about a situation that you can't change, or you flip it and think, okay, well, I'm going to sit here, think, chill, and I'm going to be home in half an hour. How lovely. And I think that's such a good way. I think your perception and how you perceive things. I mean, I know it's hard. It's been a long day at work, whatever. And you just want to get home. But I just thought it's so interesting because it's so true. And you could so easily make such a, you know, just feeling better because you feeling negative about a situation you can't change. If you can then flip it around, I think that's a very cool tool to have. Dexter and Octave, thank you so much for following. I'm AKA 6'3". Ooh, you're tall. Yeah, Millie's very positive as well, for sure. I think that's something we really get along with, actually. Reason why, one of the reasons we get along so well is because we are both positive. Because when you're around people that are just negative about everything, look, I'm no saint. I'm not positive 24/7, miss happy, miss, you know. I have my flaws. However, if you're with someone and they're just moaning and negative, and do you know what, something I hate as well? Bitchiness. People that just, honestly, I've noticed as I've gotten older, if I'm in a situation and people are just chatting negatively about other people, I switch off. Okay, everyone, you know, you'll get annoyed about someone, I'll say something. But it's when you're literally out and about and people be like, oh my God, why is she wearing that? Or, oh my, and people do. And I'll be like, why does some girl over there who you don't know cross your mind that you need to start thinking negatively about the way she's dressing? Like, let her bloody dress the way she wants to dress. I hate it. And honestly, I think too many people are too bitchy, in my opinion. My new generation would be vocal feeling. Yeah, vocalizing how you're feeling and also knowing how to express how you're feeling. So another thing I learned recently, guys, another podcast I was listening to, and they were talking about, it's actually so important to learn how to speak your emotions, which I think is so incredible, because a lot of people don't understand, like, don't know how to, so you're feeling something, right? But you don't know how to express that feeling. And I think that's so, there's so many times I'll be in an argument or something, I'm so angry or I'm so sad or whatever, I'm feeling so much emotion, but I don't know how to say it, and I don't say how I'm feeling properly. And I actually think it's so crucial to actually have language. See, I'm trying to express it now and I can't even. I'm the worst at it, but actually have language to express your feelings. We are humans, yeah. I'm tired after work, exhausted, but I like to cook. Is that what makes you happy, Kenneth? You've got your ups and downs. Everybody has their ups and downs. There are a lot of people with negative energy in this world, so seeing someone with your personality is so refreshing. I also try to be very positive. Oh, thank you so much, Mark. That's a great quality of women everywhere, especially these days. Yeah, I think it's lovely. And Tasha, no, not at all theoretical. Come on now. How old are you? I am 23. Still young, I'm 28. Oh, nice. The less I care about satisfying others' opinions. Yeah, honestly, I was reading a book recently, guys. I'm actually such a nerd. It's all coming out today, but I was actually reading a book recently, and it was just sort of like, you know how when you meet people, you're automatically thinking, what do they think about you, right? You're like, do they like me? Do they this? Do they that? Instead of thinking that, you need to be like, do I like them? Not in a negative way, not in a bitchy way, not tearing the pound, but think, did I agree with what they were saying? Did I enjoy being in their presence? And would I want to be in their presence again? And it made me realise, because I read this book after actually going out, being in a social situation, and actually the next day feeling very anxious, because I was like, oh, how did they feel about me? Did they like me? Did they this? And then I suddenly read this book and I was like, the people that I was wasting my energy on thinking, did they like me? Did I, you know, all of this kind of thing. I actually didn't really enjoy being in their presence. Wouldn't really want to be in their presence again. and therefore should not even worry or care about what they think about me. But it's so easy to do, and I think it's something I need to stop doing as well, because yeah, I think it's a constant thing of feeling not good enough, isn't it? And you know, but it's actually very interesting. I think the only time you should care about people's opinions and stuff is that when people actually mean something to you, and you know, there should only be a small handful of people that you actually care opinions of, but it's very hard to think that way. Sorry, I had to mute for a bit. Did you get your? Ah, thank you, Link. I will check. Yes, we got it. Thank you. I'll take a look afterwards. Tiggy, a nerd. Yeah, our true friends will understand. And those who won't aren't real friends. I completely agree, Pacific. And sometimes as well, I think distancing yourself from people that don't agree with that, I think is so important as well. More like I like Tiggy's friends. Ask the questions to the people who have the opinions. Yeah. I like to be around you, read a book with you would be awesome, to be honest. I love reading, I actually do, and I don't think people expect it. I like that, do I like the analogy, basically surround yourself with the same positive energy as yourself. Yeah, Merc, I thought it was a really cool analogy as well, because, I felt like I was meant to read it that day. Like, the day that I was literally feeling so anxious about whether this person liked me and what they thought and their opinion, and I was wasting so much of my productive time and energy on literally a person, and then realising, why did I even care? I don't even want to see them again. Like, I probably wouldn't even see them. You know what I mean? People with opinions follow the world. Yeah, but the thing is, like, I think opinions are so important. I think you need opinions and you need to have your own brain and thoughts, and I think that's so exciting, and I actually love people who have different opinions, maybe a bit out there, maybe a bit crazy, not to say that they are crazy, but I find it interesting, and I love people who are passionate about things. However, I do think there's a difference between passion and, you know, and then forcing your opinion on people. It's like, I don't eat meat. And so many people are like, when I say it, they're like, what? I would never have known that you don't eat meat. Because I don't sit there ranting about why that they shouldn't eat meat. Because at the end of the day, that's you. You do you. I'll do me. I don't have an issue with you guys eating meat. Don't have an issue with me not. If you want to ask me why I don't eat meat, we can have a conversation about it. But I'm not going to sit there ranting and... And so many people, not just well over a handful of people, have come up to me and they're like, wow, so you, like, I can't believe that you don't eat meat. Like, I just wouldn't, because usually people are like eating my ear off. People who have, like, who are vegetarian or whatever, are eating my ear off about why I shouldn't eat meat. And they just couldn't believe that, like, and it's true, like, I have, and I agree, like, I do like learning languages. I speak Russian, Italian. Wow. So I get sent there. I need to learn German though, so I get sent there. That's amazing, Kenneth, that you speak so many languages. You must find it easy to learn languages then. I mean, I was brought up in Spain. I do speak Spanish, but at the same time, I should speak it better. You ever been... existential crisis? You ever been in an existential... What do you mean by that specific? I don't eat meat. I like to be healthy. People call me vegan, but I'm not vegan. I have eaten dairy recently, but I usually don't eat dairy. Usually don't eat meat, but eat fish. So I'm like pescatarian, but I say I'm vegan because it's easier. Was the inner girl I met, as you said, there's plenty of
Bitchiness, I've seen. Yeah, honestly, I think when it's bitchiness, I just switch off. I really don't like when people speak badly about other people. I mean, if someone's done something to you and, like, you know, obviously you need to speak about it, and I think that's really important too. Like, if something's bothering you or someone's bothered you, you need to speak about it. I think the worst thing to do ever, if you're hurting, no matter what it is, no matter what the situation is, keeping it inside is the worst. You have to speak about it. And if that's you speaking badly about someone, you need to get it off your chest. However, there's a difference of that, and then there's the difference of just talking shit about people to basically make you feel better. Or just to, I find that as well, like, people bitch because they have nothing better to say. And you'll be out in a girl group or whatever. And not even girl group, guys. Boys are bloody bitches too. And you'll be sat there and everyone will start just speaking badly about other people. And honestly, I just don't have time for it. Like, you ever wonder if your life has a meaning or purpose? That kind of situation. From an early age, but I think that's such a good question. When I was younger, I always wanted to be a singer. So for me, I always thought that that was going to be what my meaning or purpose was to be. However, I slowly realized that music wasn't my calling in life. Was a bit saddened by it, and then I found streaming. And I don't know, I really, really enjoy streaming, and I don't know. But at the same time, I honestly believe no matter what you do, happiness or, like, I guess it's not purpose, I guess this is like a different conversation now, but I think happiness is literally from within. So as long as you're happy, as long as you can heal yourself from within and be happy within, I think so many people try and reach for higher things, strive for perfection, strive for, if I have this, then I'll be happy, and then they get that, and then it's something else. And honestly, I think it's so important to realise that if you're like that, you'll never be happy, and you just need to learn to be happy. Even if you're in a shit situation right now, just try and do things that make you happy. Try, and because you never know where you're going to be in the future, you know. I like vegans and my meat too. I need my protein and my body, not so, not vegan, lot. So, like, yeah, it is definitely harder. I mean, I have protein powder, but again, I don't think protein powder is that good for you. Like, it has so many sweeteners and things, like artificial sweeteners. I did start eating eggs, but my body, guys, is fucked from where I basically didn't eat dairy for a year. Like, I honestly, the rashes under my arms are so sore right now, just from where I haven't eaten dairy, so I can't eat dairy anymore. You do want to be vegan. I noticed when I cut out dairy and also when I cut out meat, I felt so much better. Like, so much better. She's proper eating her paw, guys. I don't know if you can see, but it's so funny. It's so funny. She, like, proper bites her nails. I drink and smoke and eat fish, so I'm solid. Everything has a reason. You play music. Yeah, so I went to music uni. That's what I studied with, and it's just always been my thing. Like, I've always just sung. But I realised that it just wasn't making me happy anymore. Like, when I left uni, I just realised it wasn't making me happy anymore. Do you ever take advantage of your positiveness? I know people who have amazing positiveness but suffer. And they're alone mentally. How about you? Oh, yeah. No, I definitely suffer. There's definitely been times that I've been really sad. But I think something that's really helped me recently, and something that it's only a technique that I've learned recently, is if you're sad, just let yourself be sad. Cry. Have a sad day. Let it in. I think it's so easy when you're sad to try and push it away. It's the same with, like, depression as well. Not that I suffer from depression, but I know a lot in my books with people that have suffered from
depression, the worst thing you can do is try and fight it. And the best thing you can do is just let it in. I remember, actually, I've never really suffered badly from mental health. Like, but I remember this, I think it was the first lockdown, which obviously was just, when everything started, it was quite, I found it quite scary. She didn't know what was going on. It's the first time anything like that had happened, like, ever heard of. And I remember just being in bed and waking up and having a panic attack. I've never had a panic attack in my life. It was so scary. And honestly, people that suffer for them, like, and get them frequently, like, I feel for them because I now know what it feels like. But I remember hearing that, so I was just like, right, just accept it and breathe into it. And that's the thing that, like, helps me a lot. I play keyboard and guitar and flute and clarinet. Ooh, Kenneth, you play loads. Yeah, I play basic guitar and piano. I used to play better, but I haven't played them properly in years. I'm 22 and I can relate what you said, as long as you're happy. I think it's so important. I think things like Instagram and things like that can make you think that's what you need to be perfect. But I'm telling you, if you had everything they had, you'd still be wanting more. And you'd still be... I honestly don't believe perfect exists. I think even if you have what you think right now, perfect, you'd still want more. It's just the way we are as humans. So I think you just have to... It's like, you'll think, especially... external things, so you'll think, oh, if I have this, then I'll be happy. If I have this car, if I buy that bag, you're always then gonna want the next bag. I know. But yeah, I think it's so important to just do, like, daily practices or whatever, just to, like, be, you know. I can't eat ice cream. Oh really? Oh yeah, I do miss ice cream. Mint chocolate chip is my favourite ice cream flavour. Really random. I used to hate it as a kid, but I love it now. You look so thick and, like, huggable. Kenneth, don't say that I put on 2 stone. I'm gonna lose it. Sebastian, singing stream. I actually get quite nervous to sing now, guys. I think it's from where... I haven't really been singing, and it's weird because, guys, when I was at uni and things, I would perform. Why did my mind go blank then? I literally used to perform in front of, like, so many people, like, it would not bother me. Like so many people. I had, like, an 8-piece band. We'd all, like, perform, like, my original songs. Like, it was mad. It was such a cool band, and, like, I loved it. But now, the idea of literally singing some covers on Twitch from my bedroom, I feel more nervous for. I don't know what it is. I think it's just been a while. I'm a bit rusty. Also, I've been drinking a lot, partying. I haven't really, my voice isn't as it used to be, because the voice is a muscle. Like, you have to keep it working for it to, you know. But I do want to keep up singing because I don't want to, like, lose my voice or anything like that. Tiggy stream is now my new happy place. Love that podcast specific and love that quote. Thank you. What is bad and good? What way do you mean? Mint chocolate chip, my fave. I love it. Yeah, party girl. Hee hee. Guys, I'm gonna quickly run to the toilet. I'm also gonna go heat up the rest of my coffee. Cause, actually, there's literally that left. Yeah, I'm gonna heat it up. Screw it. I'll be back in a sec, guys. Bear with. I'll leave you with Lolly. Be nice to